with meteorologist Dave Anderson.
Well, let's start off here with another live look, and we'll fire up the picture outside of Ely as I continue to monitor Robinson Lake for ice out. And it isn't there yet. It's still iced up pretty tight, while the rest of the terrain is looking pretty decent. Most of the snow has melted away. Well, what we need, of course, is some heat. We're not getting it right now, and we probably won't get it until, Saturday or so, at least here in the Twin Ports. Away from the lake tomorrow, though, 50s will be achieved, and low 50s is where we're supposed to be for this time of year. So it's a slow process. We are warming up, and not everybody's getting it right away, kind of like those government checks that are coming in. But we'll see how she rolls with the 7-day forecast, which will roll your way in just a little bit. But right now, we'll unfold the current conditions at the airport in Duluth, where we have a partly sunny sky, and the current temperature is 37 degrees, and that is cooler than normal. The wind, it's going easterly, 16 miles per hour. That's been pretty gusty lately here, and maybe it'll start to slow down after tomorrow. Could stay pretty gusty, though, indeed, through tomorrow. Relative humidity right now is 59%. And our current conditions for the rest of the region include a lot of sunshine to the west, 54 degrees Big Fork, 50 in Grand Rapids. So it's already warmer for some towns, but you get into the heart of the Arrowhead, it's only 34 in Two Harbors, only 44 in Hibbing, and we have 50 in Solon Springs. Superior not reporting in right now on this map. 55 Hayward, so inland it's mild. By the lake it's on the cool side. When will we all get some heat? Like I say, maybe on Saturday. But right now we've got cooler weather in place, and so that has kicked up some snow showers. At 6 o'clock I'll show you a picture of what happened in Ely today with the snow coming down. And we do still have a chance for some of these snow showers mixed in with rain showers to continue tonight as this low pressure system continues its trek to the east. But higher pressure, at least grazing us tomorrow, should bring us dry conditions, if not sunny ones. But it won't last long. By Thursday night into Friday, trough of lower pressure up aloft could bring back a rain and snow mix at least through Friday morning. But the weekend, I think, is going to be pretty decent. So now, we take a look at the forecast here for tonight in Minnesota with low temps that'll go about 25 to 30 with a slight flurry chance continuing. Into Wisconsin and Michigan, the low temps there will be 28 to 32 with a slight chance for the flurry still popping off here and there for those folks as well. Tomorrow in Wisconsin, Michigan, 48 to 55 degrees. So if the normal is around 52, we're getting closer for some towns and getting there for others. Partly sunny skies what we'll have, and that'll hold into Minnesota as well, with temperatures cooler by the lake again, about 36 to 40 by the shore, and maybe 40 to 45 on the hills near the lake, but then 49 to even 55 farther inland. So we're all hoping for that warm-up to strike all of our towns because we're an equal opportunity bunch and we like to share the wealth. Yeah, maybe on Saturday, Sunday, Tony, that'll happen. Low 50s with some sunshine too. Already by next Monday, Tuesday, rain could return, but that could be a good thing. Fire dangers are up. A good soaker on Tuesday could help solve the problem.
Yeah, might make that risk go down a little bit. Boy, was it windy today. I thought my house was going to blow away.
You know, I've been shooting those teases at home on my own little home camera, and the wind got a hold of my tripod and took my camera down, but I caught it just in time.
Classic Duluth, always windy. Thanks, Dave.